planning to achieve one. In the present society, most of the people are dreaming to enter the prestigious legal profession. The only and the fastest way to enter this noble profession is through Sri Lanka Law College. To enter the law college, candidates must face for a competitive examination. More than 6,000 candidates sit for this examination annually, but only 240 will be selected. There you have to face for 3 examination papers. First, IQ test. Second, general knowledge paper. And finally, the language test. In this video, I'm going to give you some guidelines to build up a successful answer sheet for the English language paper of law entrance examination. This video is a little supportive hand given by ProStudies. As ProStudies, we always strive for your progress. මේ වීඩියෝ එක අපි කතා කරන්න යනවා නීති ප්‍රවේශ විභාගයේ ඉංග්‍රීසි භාෂා ප්‍රශ්න පත්‍රයට කොහොමද අපි සාර්ථක පිළිතුරක් ගොඩනගාගන්නේ කියන කාරණේ. එතකොට මේ වීඩියෝ ඇතුළේදී අපි කතා කරනවා කොහොමද ඔබට ලැබෙන කාලයේ කලමනාකරණය කරගෙන උපරිම ලකුණකට යන්න සාර්ථක උත්තරයක් ගොඩනගාගන්නේ ආරාධනා කරනවා ඔබ සියලුම දෙනාට මේ වීඩියෝ අවසාන වෙනකන් අරගෙන නීති ප්‍රවේශ විභාගයේ ඉංග්‍රීසි භාෂා ප්‍රශ්න පත්‍රයට සාර්ථක පිළිතුරක් ගොඩනගාගන්නට අපි දෙනත්තරත් සමගින් එකතු වෙමු. In the English language paper, there you have 3 hours to complete 38 questions. Right. It is not an easy task. In those 38 questions, there you have to read a lot. Because this English language paper is a lengthy paper of 8 to 10 pages. So, those readings are not much familiar to us because most of them are based on history or law. So, those two subject areas are not familiar to most of us. That's why I am telling you this is not an easy task. First 35 questions of this English language paper are quite short, but starting with the comprehension question up to the essay, there you have to read a lot, think a lot, and write a lot. In the English language paper, there are 4 main subject areas as grammar, vocabulary, comprehension, and writing. First 35 questions are based on grammar and vocabulary. So we can name them as grammar and vocabulary type questions. First 35. 36th question is the comprehension question. Comprehension means understanding. 37th question is the summarizing question. And the last but not the least question is the essay. So they are the 38 questions, and I divided them into 4 main categories as grammar questions, vocabulary questions, comprehension questions, and writing questions. And you have 3 hours to complete those 38 questions. First of all, I must tell you how to manage your time when answering those questions. But before that, I'm going to tell you the marks allocated for each of those questions. I told you that first 35 questions, that means the grammar questions and the vocabulary type questions, are quite short. And the 36th question, the comprehension question, that means understanding, they will give you a passage or an article. This passage or the article is very lengthy. That means about 350 to 400 words, right? It's a lengthy passage. Before you answer the comprehension question, you have to read the passage and understand it. Without understanding, you can't answer for those questions. So, as I told you before, this is not an easy task, because the passage or the article will not be in the simple English language. Simple means the language that we are using regularly, or our day-to-day language. Believe me, the passage or the article is not in simple English language. So, it will take a long time to read and understand the passage. Believe me, I'm telling you with my experience. I conduct classes for the law entrance candidates, and most of them couldn't answer this question within 30 minutes. So, I can surely tell you that you will take minimum of 30 minutes to complete the comprehension question. Minimum of 30 minutes to complete the comprehension question. Then, as the 37th question, you have the summarizing passage. Summarizing means you have to compress the given article or the passage into one third of its original word count. It is not an easy task too. Believe me, you will take more than 45 minutes to complete the summarizing question. So, as the minimum time, I give you 45 minutes to complete the summarizing passage. 30 minutes for the comprehension question minimum, 45 minutes for the summarizing question minimum. Then, as the 38th or the final question, you have the essay, analytical essay. Believe me, you are really lucky if you could save 30 minutes to complete your essay. You are really lucky if you could save 30 minutes for your essay. 30 minutes for the comprehension question, minimum. 45 minutes to the summarizing question, minimum. 30 minutes for the analytical essay, maximum. I'm telling you again, you are really lucky if you could save 30 minutes for the analytical essay. So, I'm going to tell you about the marks allocated for each of those questions. For the comprehension question, they will allocate 15 marks. For the summarizing question, 20 to 25 marks. I'll tell you that as I'll take it as 25. And finally, to the analytical essay, 25 marks. Altogether, 65 marks out of 100. 65 marks in last three questions. So, we can clearly identify the most important part of the paper, English language paper of the Sri Lanka Law College examination. The most important part is the last three questions: comprehension question, summarizing question, and the analytical essay. As I told you, you will take 30 minutes plus 45 minutes plus 30 minutes, altogether 1 hour and 45 minutes to complete the most important part of the English language paper of law entrance examination. 1 hour and 45 minutes out of 3 hours. Then, as the remaining, you have 1 hour and 15 minutes to answer the first 35 questions. Walanoma pahedili kara English bhasha prashna patre pradhanama prashna tuna ema naththam apita wadiyenma lakunu laba ganna puluwa prashna tunata uttara liyanna pay bhage wala ekai vinadi 45 ekai sampurnen payai vinadi 45 kiyana. ඔබට පැයයි විනාඩි 15ක් ඉතුරු වෙනවා පළමු ප්‍රශ්න 35ට උත්තර දෙන්න. නමුත් මේ පැයයි විනාඩි 45ක කාලය මම ලබා දුන්නේ අවම කාලයක්. I gave you this 145 minutes, 1 hour and 45 minutes time as the minimum time required. I told you for the comprehension question 30 minutes minimum, for the summary 45 minutes minimum, and for the analytical essay I told you that you are really lucky if you could save 30 minutes for the analytical essay. ඒ කියන්නේ මොකක්ද? ඒ කියන්නේ පළවෙනි ප්‍රශ්න 35 ලියන්න පැය 1යි මිනිත්තු 15ක් ඔබ ගත්තොත් ප්‍රශ්න පත්‍රයේ ප්‍රධානම කොටස් තුනට උත්තර ලියද්දී ඔබට කාලය මදි වෙනවා. ඒ නිසා here's the tip. You have to complete or you must complete the first 35 questions within 45 minutes. That is your task. Then you could save 30 minutes extra for the most important part of your paper. ඔබ විනාඩි 45ක් තුල පළමු ප්‍රශ්න 35ට පිළිතුරු ලිව්වොත් අමතර පැය භාගයක කාලයක් ඔබගේ ප්‍රධාන සහ වටිනාම ප්‍රශ්න තුන වෙනුවෙන් වෙන් කරගන්නට පුළුවන්. Yes, it's possible to complete the first 35 questions within 45 minutes. It's possible because those questions, I told you, those questions are based on grammar and vocabulary. If you know the answer, you know the answer. If you don't know the answer, you don't know the answer, because there is an exact answer for those questions. Not like the writing questions. Likhitava අපි කියන්නේ අපේ ලිඛිත හැකියාවන් පෙන්වන ප්‍රශ්න වල වගේ නෙමෙයි ග්‍රැමර් ව්‍යාකරණ සහ වොකැබුලරි ප්‍රශ්න වලට අපි උත්තර ලියනකොට අපි උත්තරේ හරියටම දන්නවා නම් අපි උත්තරේ දන්නවා උත්තරේ දන්නේ නැත්නම් දන්නේ නැහැ ඒ නිසා විනාඩි 45ක කාලය තුල පළමු ප්‍රශ්න 35ට පිළිතුරු සැපයීම කළ නොහැකි දෙයක් නොවේ so You must answer the first 35 questions within 45 minutes to save extra 30 minutes for the most important part of your paper. Right, that's all about time management. Now you know, last three questions, that means question number 36 to 38 carry you 65 marks. Then, first 35 questions carry you 35 marks, just one mark for each question. So, I told you that those first 35 questions are based on grammar and vocabulary. What does that mean? අමාරට කිව්වා පළවෙනි ප්‍රශ්න 35 ගොඩනැගෙන්නේ grammar සහ vocabulary කියන විෂය කරුණු පදනම්වලින්. ඒ මොකක්ද කියලා අපි බලමු. Right. What is called grammar? Grammar කියන්නේ මොකක්ද? In any kind of thing, there is a set of basic ground rules. ඕනෙම දෙයක් ක්‍රියාකාරීව තියෙන්න නම් ඒකට අදාළ නීති පද්ධතියක් හරපද්ධතියක් තියෙන්න ඕනේ. Right. Grammar is the set of rules of any language. ඕනෙම භාෂාවක නීති පද්ධතිය එහෙම නැත්නම් මේ භාෂාවේ ක්‍රියාකාරීත්වය ගෙනියන විදිය තමයි grammar නැත්නම් ව්‍යාකරණ කියලා කියන්නේ. When we speak about English grammar, there are few question types that they will be checking on your examinations. Right. अभी English grammar के अंदर आकर और वोने में English भाषा प्रश्न पत्र वही कर व्याकरण की ये ना कोटे सेम मैंने बोला ना विषय का रूप ही प्यार थी. Number one, tenses. Number two, active voice and passive voice. Number three, direct and indirect speech. Number four, if clause. Right? But in the English language paper of the law entrance examination, they will be focusing on, oh, so far they have been focusing on tenses mainly, sometimes active voice and passive voice, sometimes if gross. So you have to go through those subject areas, you have to have a clear idea about these subject areas. I'm not going to explain the subject areas here in this video because I'm only giving you a guideline to build up a successful answer, right? To build up a successful answer, you must know the structure and how to manage your time. So in this video clip, I only give you the guidelines to manage your time, and I will make you aware about the structure of the paper, right? So in these grammar type questions, they will be checking your knowledge on tenses, active voice and passive voice, sometimes if clause. In the vocabulary type questions, they will be checking the spelling errors, alphabetical order, and the set of words that you have in you. ඔයාගේ තුල තියෙන ඉංග්‍රීසි භාෂාවේ වචන පිළිබඳ දැනුම කොහොමද ඒ වචන පාවිච්චි කරන්න කියන කාරණය එයාලා මේ vocabulary type questions වලින් measure කරලා බලනවා. ඒ දැනුම කොච්චරකට තියෙනවද කියලා measure කරලා බලනවා. And in any language there are some idioms and some sayings related to that language. අපි දන්නවා අපිට සිංහල භාෂාවේ ප්‍රස්තාව පිරුළු උපමා රූපක මේ වගේ දේවල් තියෙනවා. So ඉංග්‍රීසි භාෂාවේ මේ දේවල් ඒ විදිහටම තියෙනවා. In this English language paper they will give you three to five idioms. එහෙම නැත්නම් ආප්තෝපදේශ සිංහලෙදි කිව්වොත් ආප්තෝපදේශ ලබා දෙනවා. So you have to understand the meaning. Number one, you have to write the meaning, and you have to build a meaningful sentence using that idiom. Right. එතකොට පළවෙනි ප්‍රශ්න 35 හැදෙන්නේ මෙන්න මේ කාරණා ටික පදනම් කරගෙන. There will be grammar questions, vocabulary type questions, and some idiom questions. Then the conclusion question. As I told you, they will give you a passage or an article, and they will ask questions based on that passage or the article. This passage is a lengthy passage and it is not in simple English language, so it will take some time to read and understand this passage. You may have to read it twice, three times, four times to understand the passage. So in this question, you have to read and understand the passage, and you have to answer accordingly. Sometimes those questions can be factual questions. Factual questions කියන්නේ ඔයාලට දීලා තියෙන passage එකේම තියෙන දේ ගැන ප්‍රශ්න කරනවා. Right? Sometimes those questions can be logical questions. Passage එකේ කියන දේක් කියවලා තේරුම් අරගෙන ඒක වෙනම එකට ආදේශ කරලා ලියන්න එන්න පුළුවන්. එහෙමත් නැත්නම් passage එකේ කියන දේක් එයා ඇයි එහෙම කරේ කියලා පැහැදිලි කරන්න එන්න. Right. And sometimes those questions can be vocabulary type question. That means you have to provide a single word for an explanation given. ඔයාලට දීලා තියෙන මොකක හරි තේරුමකට විස්තරයකට ගැලපෙන තනි වචනය passage එකෙන් හොයලා එන්න පුළුවන්. Oh, you have to find synonyms or antonyms. සමාන වචන බිඳ වචන හොයන්න එන්න පුළුවන්. Right? That is the nature of the comprehension question. And I told you before, this question carries 15 marks. And believe me, you will take minimum of 30 minutes to complete this question. Next question is the summarizing question. Summarizing means you have to compress a given passage or an article into one third of its original word count. This passage is also a lengthy passage, and it is not in simple language too. Summarizing question එකකට දෙන passage එක දීර්ඝ විස්තරයක් දෙන්නේ. ඒක තියෙන්නේ සරල ඉංග්‍රීසි භාෂාවෙන් නෙවෙයි. So, you have to read it well. You have to understand the passage well, and you have to reduce the word count. This is not an easy task. That's why I told you that you will take minimum of 45 minutes to complete this question. You can't insert your own ideas into the summary. You can't neglect the author's ideas. You have to give the complete idea of the passage using one third of its original word count. ඔබට ඔබේ පෞද්ගලික අදහස් සමරේට ඇතුළත් කරන්න බැහැ. රචකයාගේ අදහස් විකෘති කරන්නත් බැහැ. ඒ වගේම තමයි රචකයාගේ ප්‍රධාන කරුණු වල සාරාංශය ඔබට original text එකෙන් ඔබට දීලා තියෙන text එකෙන් වචන තුනෙන් එකක් දක්වා අඩු කරලා ලියන්නත් ඕන. එතකොට පැහැදිලිවම මේක සරල කාර්යයක් නෙමෙයි. So, what you have to do is you have to read it carefully. You have to understand the meaning. You have to point out the most important points or the ideas. Then collect those most important ideas and build up the summary. And it will give you 25 marks. Finally, the analytical essay. Analytical essay. What does that mean? Analytical means you have analyzed the given topic or the selected topic. There can be choices, 3 to 4 topics. Those topics are not easy. They won't give you topics to write about your home guard, your pet, your mother country. No. Most of those topics are based on history, culture of the society, and the contemporary issues of the country. ඔබට කවදාවත් ඔබේ ගෙවත්ත මගේ සුරතලා ගැන ලියන්න රචනා මාතෘකා දෙන්නේ නැහැ. right? මේ දෙන මාතෘකා එක්ක රටේ සංස්කෘතිය හා ඉතිහාසය මත පදනම්ව දෙන්නේ. එහෙම නැත්නම් නීතිය සම්බන්ධයෙන් දෙන්නේ. එහෙමත් නැත්නම් රටේ තියෙන වර්තමාන තත්ත්වය, ලෝකේ තියෙන වර්තමාන තත්ත්වයත් එක්ක ගැළපෙන මාතෘකාවක් තමයි දෙන්නේ. So, it is not easy to write an analytical essay to that kind of a topic. So, what you have to do is, you have to get a proper introduction, you have to point out your facts, right? Positive facts, negative facts, and you have to give some solutions to those negative facts. Finally, you have to conclude the essay. So, your essay must have 3 main parts. First one is the introduction, second one is the body, and finally, a conclusion. So, you have to write this essay within 275 minimum to 325 maximum word count. They suggest you to write a 300 words, write an essay of 300 words as the word count. Right? වචන 300ක essay එකක් කියන්න කියලා තමයි කියන්නේ. එතකොට මේකේ minimum අවම වචන සංඛ්‍යාව වෙන්නේ වචන 275. උපරිම වචන සංඛ්‍යාව වෙන්නේ වචන 325. So, I suggest you to write an essay of 310 to 315 words. That will be perfect. So, within those 315 words, you have to analyze the given topic, you have to give an introduction, you have to point out the positive facts, point out the negative facts, then you have to analyze. So, you have to give positive solutions to those negative facts, and you have to conclude your essay in a positive manner. Right? So, this is the way that you have to follow to build up a successful answer to the English language paper of the Lawyer's examination. Hope to meet you with more videos, and remember the name. Pro Studies, we always strive for your progress. Thank you for joining.